Hello, my name is Dr. Janet Rennie and I'm a consultant neonatologist here at University College Hospital in London. I have a long-standing interest in brain injury in newborn babies and I work with a large group of engineers, neurophysiologists and other neonatologists. We are working on the topic of neonatal seizures, baby fits. Our group includes members of clinical staff from other London hospitals, both the Homerton and the Royal London Hospital. And we have a big group of biomedical engineers and scientists at University College Cork in Ireland. And we have clinical collaborators in Dublin and at the Karolinska Hospital in Sweden and in Holland. The problem is important because it is very difficult to recognise when a baby is having a fit, much more difficult than it is to recognise seizures in older children or adults. And really the only reliable way to detect seizures in babies is to measure the baby's brain waves. The equipment for picking up and recording the EEG signal from the scalp has improved considerably over the time that I've been involved with the newborn over the last 20 years, and the days of mountains and mountains of paper are now completely gone. And we have got very compact cot-side monitors which are capable of storing and recording 72 hours or more of EEG. So that's a significant advantage. And now we're cooling babies to protect their brains. It's really common for us to carry on recording the brain waves for several days. The problem for the clinical team is how to interpret the signal. And that requires highly specialised skills which are not readily available 24/7 and not available in any baby unit. So we fit in our research by trying to help people understand how to interpret these signals. And this is an example of a brainwave trace from a baby, which is a highly complex signal. And this is an example of a seizure. The top trace is a very compressed EEG signal, which is running over about 8 hours, and sometimes does provide a clue to the clinical team to look at the brainwave trace below. And on this particular slide, there's an example of a brainwave trace, which is just 8 seconds. And together with that, we've got the baby's respiration and heartbeat and the baby's oxygen saturation, and we can see changes in those parameters. But this particular seizure is quite easy to recognise, but you can see that how difficult it could be to look at a very, very long recording and analyse that whole recording. And our goal really is to help with that. We've been very lucky because we've had fantastic support from the Wellcome Trust, who've given us a technology transfer grant to develop computer software, and this analyses the EEG automatically in order to detect whether or not a seizure is present. This has been a very challenging engineering task because of the complexity of the signal and because not all seizures look the same and they're not all the same duration. And over very long recordings you can get interference from outside or from respiration or from the mum just patting on the baby. Many other groups around the world have tried and failed to do this, but we're very pleased because we have reached the point now where our algorithm performs pretty well as a human expert. And of course the great advantage of an algorithm is it's permanently available 24/7, it never gets tired, and it never needs to go home at night. So we're really hoping that this is going to be a success. And we are about to start a clinical trial of this algorithm. And we will be asking parents of babies that we think might be suffering from baby seizures to allow us to test it out at the cot side. And we hope by doing that we'll be able to capture the seizures earlier and recognise them more reliably and accurately, and we'll be able to monitor the effects of our treatment so that we don't give too much treatment or too little treatment in order to control the seizures. This is a picture of the mock-up of how the kit will look sitting at the cot side, with our algorithm running alongside existing monitoring systems. And the automated algorithm would analyse the e-signal constantly in real time and constantly put out an indication of probability of seizure. And when the probability rises, it will put out a little alarm and look red. And that will clue in the clinical team to look at the brainwave trace and look at the baby. Obviously, treatment won't be based upon the algorithm until we've tested it out. So we're really at a very exciting phase, and we're delighted to have the opportunity to test this algorithm now and to maybe get it out around the world. and we hope very much that by doing this we'll be able to improve the outcome for neurologically sick babies, and in particular in future working on better ways to treat seizures. And we hope to develop it further so that we can test it out on premature babies. At the moment we only do bigger babies, and also on being able to help clinical staff look at the background rhythms of the brain as well as baby seizures. So it's really going to be an exciting